Hey guys, what's going on? Walp and Web Snappers here. Today I'm going to be bringing you a new type of video, one where I kind of tell you guys how I go about setting figures up and creating displays the way that mine look. And I thought I could give you guys some tips on how to do it and how kind of not to do it and what to stay away from to help improve your displays at home. So my goal is trying to tell you guys how I get inspiration, how I go about posing, and how to kind of create displays that look like this image and look like they're popping out of a comic book cover. So without further ado, let's get right into this video. To start out your collection, you gotta have some base or form of inspiration. For me, that was Avengers Earth's Mightiest Heroes. So I wanted the core of my collection to be founded on these core member of Avengers that I saw in the show. And I just don't think you can beat the classics. When it comes to setting up your display, I highly recommend you pick figures from books that you love reading or versions of characters you love. For me, I loved reading Brian Michael Bendis's run on the New Avengers and Avengers. There's just something about that that I love from his characters that he creates and the mix of classic and modern. I just love looking at it and reading it. I use this image also for lots of inspiration, as I think that every character here is more or less their definitive look. But I also like to take a mix of this image here, where I take iconic, bright, flashy, classic looks and mix it with other characters that I prefer their modern look. So putting the figures in place can be like putting a puzzle together. Start off basic. Put your bigger figures in the back. Don't put them in any crazy dynamic pose so you can save room for other figures. Next, find out who you want to be a leader or center focus of your team. I will always stick with Cap, with Iron Man close behind. Put your leading figure towards the middle, usually face forward. After you have your center stage, go ahead and put more bigger figures towards the back. You want to be able to see everyone and still have your group look symmetric. I like to make a triangle shape with the display, with Captain America kind of being the point, and then it gets bigger towards the back. Add in layers and try to get figures into empty spaces. Make sure you also diversify your poses so not all your figures are at the same height. You're also going to want to diversify your display with kind of posing. So you're going to want to put a figure kind of towards the front a little. I'm going to put Iron Fist up front and put him in this kind of Kung Fu battle ready pose so he's not covering anyone up, and it looks pretty cool and adds some more depth to that display. Next, you should really use a flight stand. They add so much dynamicism to your display. I like to make sure that I don't cover anyone up when I use them. Use flight stands for characters that fly or are agile, and remember that you want the poses to capture the essence of that character. And then you should also use other characters to cover up the rod from the flight stand, kind of like how I'm using Iron Fist to do that right now. Here I'm tweaking Iron Man because I want to get him more into a pose that I think suits him more, using his Repulsor Blast, which is an effect that I think really adds to this display and character. So I like to keep the symmetry in the display. So I'm going to add Spidey crouching on the other side. And that's another big thing is I keep the essence of Spider-Man in that character as he's a crouching and more agile. He's got his hands out and it looks really good. And I think it's starting to really look symmetrical and like that triangle shape that I've been wanting and that I've been telling you guys. And it also helps with the layering effect. So next I'm going to add a flying character. So when you're putting a flying character in, make sure that they kind of face the direction and the side that they are. So I have Jessica Jones. To us, she's facing the left, but I have her tilted facing, so she's facing the right. So I have her kind of towards the right there. And that kind of also applies for any figure. If they're on the left side, make sure they're facing the left a little or tilted towards the left. And if they're on the right, make sure they're towards the right. And I think it really looks good. So I think I'm gonna have to add another figure there that doesn't contrast the colors. So I need a dark character to cover up that pole. So I'm thinking I'm gonna put Miss Marvel there and just keep a basic pose. just for the purpose of this video, and then I'll put her in, and she fits like a perfect puzzle piece there. And I really like how this looks, and I think the colors all clash really well. So yeah, you kind of get the idea here, and it looks like it's all pretty much equally spread out. And then since my shelves are up by the ceiling, I'll add characters that fly more like right here and here. So some of the major takeaways from this video should be to add the layers and make sure that figures are staggered and all kind of point towards a single point. Make sure when you're using a flight stand that you cover it up with another figure so it's not visible that it's using a flight stand. Now here are some things to try and stay away from. First off, stay away from simple staggering, just a basic line of figures, very undynamic. And color mashing is another thing, like the Hulk and Vision and Hawkeye and Thor's or Hulk's pants. They just don't look good together. And these three black figures towards the back, it just doesn't mash well together. One final word of advice is work with the comics that you're familiar with and characters that you're familiar with. And if you don't know them, do some research and get to know them a little better. But really just get creative, have fun, and kind of make the display how you like to see it. And it's kind of the beauty of it all. Thanks guys for watching this video and being supportive and commenting. I love chatting with you guys. And stay tuned for more content like this, and I'll see you in the next video.